What if I told you I knew an easy way to improve your app performance and grow your revenue as a result? Let me explain. How many times did you click on a web link just to see a loading screen in the browser for what feels like an eternity? My guess is that this happens pretty often. It should not come as a surprise that this waiting time has big consequences on both user experience and revenue. Here are some quick stats. According to Google, your users are 32% more likely to bounce from your app when the load speed goes from 1 to 3 seconds. If the load speed goes up to 5 seconds, the bounce rate increases dramatically and you are likely to lose up to 90% of your potential customers. While your code might be the main reason for your slow app, and, let's be honest, that's the case more often than not, there is also this small thing called latency, which can add up to 1 second of delay on a request-response round trip. When this time adds up, customers become frustrated, and they'll be less likely to use your services. You don't believe me? Let's spend the next few minutes looking at the impact latency has on your apps, and how serverless at the edge can help you improve UX and make more money. To put things into context, we'll briefly review how we got from a single server in a random basement to the complex serverless cloud infrastructure we are using today. Going back to the 60s, the IBM 360 Model 91 was the first machine used by UCLA to provide production computing services, such as a mailbox or FTP to ARPANET users. This marks the beginning of the server era, with machines offering processing power and memory for various services exposed to the internet. This simple architecture is still heavily used today, and large companies have entire departments of engineers who mostly work on maintaining, deploying, and scaling clusters of dedicated servers. Besides the obvious complexity, this approach has one major drawback. The server hosting your application is usually physically located in only one location, and, in this day and age, it is fairly common for users to access your app from anywhere in the world. To alleviate part of the problem, companies launched the idea of content delivery networks. These CDNs cached content in a distributed system of servers so that incoming requests could be routed to a server closer to the end user. While powerful, your regular CDNs have a pretty obvious limitation. They can cache and serve static files such as JavaScript, CSS, or images, but the computing aspect still remains on a single location server. Because of its benefits, cloud computing got really popular during the years, and horizontal scaling across multiple availability zones is the norm when working with providers such as AWS. In 2014, AWS Lambda became the first serverless framework that saw widespread adoption. The elevator pitch was convincing. Defer all server management to AWS and pay only for the resources you are using when you are using them. However, this freedom comes at a cost, since you lose on the performance front. Serverless functions have to be provisioned, leading to latency issues. On top of that, despite the name, serverless functions are usually still hosted on centralized servers, which might imply long round trips and increased latency. Fast forward a couple of years, and Cloudflare launches Workers, a solution to run JavaScript service workers at the edge. So now, you can compute closer to the end user, reaching an over-the-wire performance similar to what CDNs are offering for static assets. As a consequence, computing at the edge is slowly getting traction, and frameworks such as Hono.js were developed for this type of work. Today, there are many more serverless edge providers, including Deno Deploy. Here are the main benefits leading to the increased popularity of serverless. First of all, the increased performance should be obvious by now. Code running globally, physically close to end users, means lower network latency. Providers such as Deno Deploy use V8 isolates, which lead to minimal cold start times and even lower latency. To give you an idea about the actual difference a platform like Deno is making when it comes to performance, here is a time-to-first-byte comparison between apps hosted in Heroku and Deno Deploy. By default, runtimes in Heroku are deployed in the AWS data center located in Virginia. While North American users will have fairly low latencies, requests from Asia will end up being close to 1 second slower due to the large distance between locations. If you believe that the 1 second statement I made at the beginning of this video was an exaggeration, here is the data to back up my claim. Another big benefit of using serverless at the edge is security. Before, the browser or device would make API calls to the server. However, if you move the compute process of the device and to the edge, you end up with simply exchanging HTML and CSS over the wire. Of course, this will remove an entire vector of attack. DDoS attacks will also be more difficult, since attackers need to take down dozens, hundreds, or maybe even thousands of servers across the world. Finally, developers are using Edge functions because of the better developer experience. For instance, using Deno Deploy, you can seamlessly deploy full-stack apps with powerful backends, native storage solutions, and performant front-end frameworks. All you need to do is merge your code into a main Git branch, and your updates will be visible in mere seconds. On top of that, the Fresh framework is built to take full advantage of the Edge. It has an HTML-first approach and sends zero JavaScript to the client by default. Any JS needs your app might have in the client are then filled using the Islands architecture. If you use Fresh with Deno Deploy, the chances are you'll easily get a perfect Lighthouse score. To supercharge building global apps on Deno Deploy, a KV storage solution is now built in directly in the runtime. This means you can connect to a globally distributed and replicated production database with a single line of code. No separate step to provision a database or copying and pasting keys into environment variables. And to make it even easier, the SaaS Kit template offers you out of the box features such as Stripe payments or authentication. So you get the point. Deno managed to build a rich ecosystem of libraries and tools around it. All these tools are leveraging the latest best practices in the industry. Apps are built using techniques such as the Islands architecture, server-side rendering, progressive enhancement, or web APIs, and they are constantly getting 100% scores in Lighthouse. If you found this video useful and you want to stay in touch with the Deno ecosystem, please click the like and subscribe buttons.